There's been a couple times where we've gotten a little too drunk and then we started talking shit about people. And I was like, oh yeah, fuck you too, Jennifer. And I was like, oh, wait.
Those are the best moments though. Like, mm-hmm. I would think that it's funny. I mean, yeah. I would just be like, oh, well, like, I said it, like, what is Jennifer gonna do? Beat me up. Exactly. You know, there was a point in time where there was a bank that got robbed by someone on a bicycle.
No.
And they, no. They never caught him.
No. Emotional, like people say, oh, women are always really emotional and guys are like more I don't even know, whatever, but they always say women are more emotional. I don't think that's true, because anger is an emotion, and every dude I know is angry or can express anger like really, yeah, really bad and do a lot of things out of anger. So I don't know, I think that men are just as emotional. It's just not the emotions you're thinking. Like, a lot of men, yeah, are angry.
Like, they don't know how to process their emotions. Exactly. Because they were never taught how to process.
But they're, like, that feeling is still there. Yeah, that, yeah, those feelings are still there. They just, it comes out in anger instead of... I don't even want to do an intro or anything. I just kind of jump into it. But before I ask you, the first question I want to ask you is... how are you doing? Like, we cut up a little bit, but like, how are you doing?
Oh, I'm good, you know? Yeah. I just, I enjoy my job that I have now.
Yeah, what do you do now?
Better. So I'm a scheduler at a gastroenterologist office. So okay. I schedule like doctor's appointments, I schedule procedures, I give people their prep instructions and then go over, you know, their insurance benefits as far as that goes with, yeah, them and stuff like that.
That sounds much more wholesome than Walmart.
Yeah.
Way more wholesome than Walmart. Oh my God. You know, some of the best friends I've ever met were working at Walmart. Right. And I'm so glad that most of them have gotten out, because like, the people I've met have been really cool. The job, consistently shitty.
Yeah.
Consistently, yeah, shitty. Okay. So what I want to start off by asking you is, and this won't be an interview, but I kind of want to ask this at the beginning to just see if you've thought about it. Okay. Is, at what point in your life, if you've gotten there yet, maybe not, do you feel like you've become an adult? Like, what was that point in your life where like, damn, I'm an adult now?
Ooh, that's a good question. Probably like when I started paying rent and stuff, you know, because
yeah, that is,
I was like, oh, yeah, you know, because before, like, I remember, you know, before I moved out on my own, like, I was living with, before I moved to like Vegas and stuff, I was living with my dad. Mm-hmm. Like, I had a car. I didn't have a car note to pay, because nice, my car was paid off. So I really just had to worry about insurance and having food to eat. And I was like living such a lavish life. Like, I was ordering stuff from Fashion Nova like every week.
Yeah.
I was
Amazon card is full.
Right. Like, I was having extravagant meals. Like, I was just like, yeah, I'm gonna eat there today, eat there tomorrow. And then like, once I, you know, got out on my own and I had to like, you know, actually pay rent and stuff, and I couldn't do those things like, you know, like I wanted to anymore. I was like, oh, okay,
it hurts. You're like, they don't want half the rent, they want the whole rent.
Yeah,
the
first, I'm like, month. Wow, like, this is, I have to pay to live here, really? Like, and then there's other stuff that goes with it. Like, I have to pay for the electricity,
I gotta pay for water too, I can't take those hour-long showers anymore.
I'm just like, yeah, I think that's when it was really like, wow, I'm really an adult paying bills out here. Like, that's crazy.
Do you think that was too early in life, or just about the right time?
I would say, well, considering like my circumstances, like, yeah, I would say that it was like just about the right time, because like at that point, like, I was like over living with my dad. Gotcha. And then, you know, my mom had kind of like, you know, moved, and you know, she was in a relationship, and you know, she ended up moving to a different state that I didn't want to go to. So I mean, and I've always been very independent anyway, so like, I was getting to that point to where I was like, I want my own apartment, because like, yeah, I had friends that already had their own apartment, so I was like, I want my own apartment, you know, but not really thinking like what all comes with,
yeah,
it.
Yeah, there's a lot with it.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you always, ever since I met you, you give off that persona that you like to be independent, which I think is really cool. Not a lot of people have that or want that, but it's really cool when you can just like do your own thing and make your own decisions and do whatever the fuck you want and move out. I did actually before recording, I didn't tell you, but it doesn't matter. I mean, feel free to share as much as you want, as much as you don't want. If you say something, you're like, oh, fuck, maybe I shouldn't have said that. We can always edit it out or bleep it out.
Okay, cool.
Or anything. yeah, don't worry about that. I forgot to mention that at first because there's been a couple times where we've gotten a little too drunk and then we started talking shit about people. And I was like, oh yeah, fuck you too, Jennifer. And I was like, oh, wait.
Those are the best moments though. Like, mm-hmm. I would think that it's funny. I mean, yeah. I would just be like, oh, well, like I said it. Like, what is Jennifer going to do? Beat me up.
Exactly.
She's
going to
beat me up.
By the end of the video, we're like talking massive shit about this girl named Jennifer. I don't know. I made that up. But like, it did get that close. There was one where I had to beep out like 20 minutes of us talking shit about somebody.
Oh my gosh.
I remember we were talking and I said, I looked at the camera, I'm like, dude, right here, right now, cut that shit. This is not good. Oh god. Okay. So I wanted to have a podcast about relationships for a long time, but I've been single for like 3 years now, so I'm probably not the best resource. Well, I'll tell you about that later. But so I'm probably not the best resource. For that kind of stuff. And you've been in a relationship for how long now?
4 years.
4 years. To very, and you've lived together for that.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, that's impressive. So you have a lot of stuff that I obviously don't know. And I have been in the dating game, I guess, more recent than you have as a result. So mm-hmm. I'm interested to see where it goes. I say I'll tell you later because the last podcast episode, it was revealed. They claim, I didn't do this, but people claim that I had 3 girlfriends at one time.
What? Oh, you've really been out here living it up. You've been living your best life.
I was not dating 3 people at the same time.
The universe was working against
me. Working against me. It was telling me I was fucking something up. So anyways, I'm probably not the best resource for any of this. Platonic relationships between male and female. I think a lot of people say, oh, especially once you get in a relationship too. I've had a lot of people that have had to cut me out of their lives, or I've had to cut them out of my lives because I'm dating someone or they're dating someone. Mm-hmm. And they're like, you just can't be friends with them. And I don't know. I think it's possible to have just like a purely platonic just friendship with someone. Not everything has to be, oh, I'm going to hit on them. Oh, I'm going to try to have sex with them. Oh, I'm going to, I don't know, slowly flirt with them until like something else happens. I don't know.
I agree. I mean, and I guess it really depends on like the person, like, because I feel like if you have an issue with your significant other like having a friend of the opposite gender, then that's just your own insecurities. Mm-hmm. Because I wouldn't say I have a lot of male friends, but I do have male friends, like probably not any that I would just like go and hang out with, you know, like
yeah,
by myself or whatever. But
right.
I do have like male friends and it's like strictly just a friendship. Like there's no attraction between us like whatsoever. Yeah. You know, like when we have conversations, it's just like literally like normal conversations like that I would
making
have
fun of shit or sending
yeah,
memes.
Like yeah. A female friend or whatever, you know. But it's definitely possible. I just feel like that's all about like being insecure, if that's yeah. an issue in a relationship.
No, I think you're right, because there's have to be something new that says, oh, if this person's gonna hang out with someone of the opposite gender, they might do something. And it's like, you should be really secure about your relationship. I mean, I can't speak yeah. too much, right, because I've been out of it for a while, but like the communication was always so important to me. I can't imagine not, like, just being, like, waking up and doing whatever you want. Like, obviously, you don't have to, like, ask for permission for everything, but, like, that checking in and, like, communication is, I think, is really big.
Yeah, for sure.
Because I've always thought it's okay to have, like, friends of the opposite sex, especially because I've been told I come across as flirty. I don't think so. But I mean, I like to send memes, I like to make people laugh and stuff.
Yeah.
And oftentimes a lot of people mistake that for flirting. So like, oh, you were trying to flirt with this person. No, I was just trying to make them laugh. Like, I thought this would be funny. Like I know you like dark humor. So yeah. I'm going to send you some dark shit because right. I thought it was dark. I'm like, she's going to appreciate it. Like, I like to see my friends laugh.
Right.
And before in previous relationships, that's like always been misunderstood as well. Like, oh, you're just texting other people. I'm like, no, I mean, like, they're my friends. This is humor. Yeah. They're like, this is just humor. And I think it's really easy to get that misconstrued. But mm-hmm. I guess we all have this feeling of like wanting to be with somebody and then like maybe jumping the gun a little too quick and not even like worried about fixing ourselves or maybe talking to someone and getting therapy or anything.
Oh yeah, for sure.
And I think it's really difficult now. There was a class I took where they asked this question. Do you think people lie on first dates or lie to make really good first impressions in general? And the whole class and everybody said yes. And then the professor was like, so why does everybody do it? Why can't just we be real with people?
I don't know. I mean, I do feel like a lot of people do lie to like impress someone. I mean, like me personally, like I don't think I've ever lied to someone on a first date because I've just never really been that type of person to like really be trying to impress someone. Mm-hmm. It's just like either you like me or you don't.
Yeah.
But I don't know.
You don't want to do extra work. Because that's like, not you. Yeah.
I feel like some people like just do that because I don't know. Maybe it's like an impulsive lie where they're just like, oh, I'm nervous. So like.
Like I have to be perfect for this person.
Like they just don't want to look bad in front of, like they're afraid of looking bad or like they value. Like, cause you know, some people, they really value other people's opinions like so much. Like they really care so much about what other people think about them.
Can be us.
Yeah. So I really just feel like that's kind of like just some people's mentality. It has everything to do with your mentality, basically.
And then you disappoint the other person anyway, because you're not who you said you were.
Yeah.
And then you're also a liar. So it's like, it just gets worse and worse.
I thought you said you were going to buy me a Mercedes. Like what? Why would you say
that? Oh yeah, you will never catch me saying that.
Right, like I never understand when people like, I could see, you know, telling like a little small lie or whatever. Like,
sure.
Yeah, I used to play football in high school.
Yeah, and, I mean, who doesn't lie about that? You know, like, right, who like doesn't that? Lie about that?
But you're telling someone like, you know, I'm going to buy you a house. I'm going to put you in a mansion.
Yeah,
buy you a Mercedes. And then like,
where's in a Mercedes? a year in, you're like, I haven't had any of these things.
Yeah, and it's like, what did you say that for? Like,
this is a one bedroom apartment.
Right, like, and it's always like so unprovoked. Like, because no one, I didn't ask you for a Mercedes.
Exactly.
Like, that wasn't even on my mind. You initiated that.
I would have been happy here if you didn't set my expectations so
high. Exactly. But
like,
people just need to just tell the truth. Don't,
yeah.
You don't have to put up a front, because if you do, then obviously like that person is not for you.
Yeah, true, true. If it's not gonna work out, like don't force something that isn't there.
Yeah.
Don't ever force something that's not there.
Yeah, basically.
If it's not, if you meet the person and you're not getting along with them, or they're not hitting the right cues, or the body language is weird, or something's just not right, don't force something that's not there.
Oh yeah, I hate forced things.
I had that happened a couple of months ago where it felt like we were both trying to force something that wasn't there, and at the end of the day we didn't even like meet up with each other to say goodbye. We were like texting, which sucks. I use audio a lot. I was like, I'm just not gonna try to continue to force something that's not there. It obviously seems like there's just something not right about this. I wish you the best, and then, you know, leave it there. But it's a learning experience for everyone.
Yeah,
or at least you should take it as a learning experience. I took it as a learning experience. I've had a lot of relationships where I feel like I've given way too much, and then when I try to date again, I'm like super closed off and reserved. And I've like finally learned that. So I thought, okay, there's a happy balance between like overextending yourself in the beginning, and then there's also like, you can tell when it's bad that people don't want to open up and don't want to share, don't want to be emotionally available, which is hard for guys. But
yeah, it definitely
there's a balance. And
why do
that
you think that's like so, well, since you're a guy and you can answer this, like, why do you think that it's so hard for men to be emotionally available?
The short answer is society. The long answer is also society, but more in depth. I think from a really young age we get told that like the men just aren't supposed to show feelings. Like I remember for myself, when I would get hurt or something, they would say men don't cry. I remember that constantly being ingrained. You want to be a man, you want to start working as soon as you can. So like I started working at like 10, and I remember working really hard jobs at like 14 and 15. And they were like, if you want to become a man, this is what you have to do. And that, like, it makes you repress all of the other things. Like, there's no mental health, there's no like emotional talk, there's nothing that other people or maybe even girls might get included in like the manuscript on how to become a man.
I agree with that. I always felt like that I've always felt like that it's not really fair that like, you know, men get taught from a young age like, oh, you don't do this because you're a man. That's not what a man does. You can't show your emotions because you're a man. And I'm like, what's wrong with that? Like,
yeah,
I like emotional men to a certain extent. Yeah. Like, you know, let me know how you feel and whatever. Yeah. Like,
you want someone that can see your communicate emotions.
Like, don't be so nonchalant about everything. Like, you don't care.
Be chalant.
But also, like, don't be crying and throwing up in a corner because that like, looks bad. I won't let you have your way or something.
Yeah, because that's just bad.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not your mom.
Right, exactly. I also feel like a lot of like, and I'm not labeling it on like every man, but I feel like a lot of men have mommy issues.
Yeah, sure.
I just like a lot of women have daddy issues.
Yeah, but that's yeah, no, I agree. That's totally a thing. But I actually think when people say men aren't good at just expressing their emotions, that's true. But that doesn't make them less emotional. Like people say, oh, women are always really emotional and guys are like more I don't even know, whatever, but they always say women are more emotional. I don't think that's true, because anger is an emotion, and every dude I know is angry or can express anger like really, really bad and do a lot of things out of anger. So I don't know, I think that men are just as emotional. It's just not the emotions you're thinking. Like a lot of men are angry.
Like, they don't know how to process their emotions because they were never taught how to process.
But they're like, that feeling is still there. Yeah, those feelings are still there. They just, it comes out in anger instead of like sadness or like, you know, whatever else it is. And that, I think that's just a push in general for like people having families and like society in general to include men in that. Because to say that men are just not emotional is so not true. So not true.
Oh yeah, I've definitely met a couple of emotional men in my entire life. And it was very weird to me because I'm just like, oh my God, you're emotional. Like,
yeah.
This is so weird.
And then the ones that aren't, they probably have anger issues.
Yep. And I feel like they have anger issues because like they just have like so many different emotions and they don't know how to like process them. They don't know how to express them because like they were always just taught to just push it down, like suck it up, you're a man.
Yeah, you know? Just continue repressing
it. And I just don't think that that's fair. I mean, because at the end of the day, like we're all human. Like we all have emotions, and I feel like everybody should be able to express their emotions or be taught how to process it.
Yeah.
You know, like I feel like being a man doesn't have anything to do with being emotional. Like just because you're emotional, that doesn't make you less of a man.
Right. You're just human. Yeah, you're just human.
Yeah, you're just human.
It's just something that you're going to experience. Yeah. I mean, I wish we had, like in middle school, it would have been really nice to have a class that was kind of centered towards like being a better person or like just being comfortable with yourself. Because I remember we had health and they taught us like sex ed and stuff, which was not enough at all. It was like it was like 45 minutes one day and it's like, okay, that's what it is, which is not enough. But maybe having a class or even included in that shows you how to, I don't know, talk to people and handle your emotions.
Yeah,
because from there on out, like from 6th, 7th grade on out, like that is who you become. And that, I feel like that had a really big influence on who I am now.
Yeah, I agree. Because like some people could definitely like benefit from like a class like that. Because just like, well, like you're a really shitty person. Like you need to like take a class.
How does someone get this shitty?
Right. Yeah. It's just like, you think that this behavior is okay?
Like, like life sucks for all of us.
Right. It's like, you think you're the only one? Like you don't have to be an asshole because you had a bad life. Like,
exactly.
That doesn't have anything to do with it.
We all struggled. Yeah. But then also you have to be really careful when you, when you talk about these things, because if you start like advocating a little too much for men, then like people get mad at that too. But it's just a happy balance. Like, I think the way we're doing it now, like just saying, hey, we're all human, like we all feel this shit, like that's really good. But yeah. Then some people say like, oh, you give men too much credit. And then there's people on the opposite extreme that are like telling men they should have as many wives as they can and all they should do is abuse women. And it's like, well, that's not good either. Like, there's a happy balance between like caring way too much and then like not caring enough. I don't do this because I don't like to. But like if you're shooting your shot on like Instagram or something, all you have is like their profile and such. Mm-hmm. And in your profile, you're probably only going to show like the highlights of your life. You're never going to show like the down or like the crazy you or the delusional you or like the everyday Sure. You're just going to show like the best version of you. So like you hit somebody up there and you meet in person and it turns out they're not what you were expecting. Like that also happens too.
Yeah.
And I can do it. I cannot.
I feel like that happens in real life too, because like I've definitely like in the past have like, you know, met someone, you know, I hung out with them a couple of times. So I'm like, okay, they seem cool. And then like when it gets deeper and I'm like, oh wow, like he's totally
this explains a lot.
I'm like, what I thought, like he's like, I didn't know he was like that. Like I didn't know it was gonna be all that. You know, but definitely, like, yeah, you definitely cannot like base like a person, like, you know, go off of someone's social media based on what's there, because like social media is definitely not going to help you understand someone, because a lot of people put on a front for social media.
Like everybody does.
I have seen people like, you know, they're posting money and stuff on Instagram and flashy jewelry and
shit they don't have.
Nothing. It's just like, that is not even yours. And I never understood that, because it's just like,
put that down. That ain't your chain. Yeah, we all know like, that ain't your chain.
We know that doesn't belong to you.
Like, what are you wearing?
It's like, you work at Chick-fil-A. How can you afford a Johnny Bench? Like,
boy, we know that ain't a Rolex.
Not, you know, saying there's anything wrong with Chick-fil-A, but like, if you're working at Chick-fil-A, you don't need to be wearing like flashy jewelry like that. I mean,
you don't need the Gucci shoes to pull up to Chick-fil-A.
Exactly. Like, why are you wearing Gucci shoes, like, and you're driving like a 2005 Nissan Altima?
That's got the back bumper fucked up.
Right. Like, your bumper is gone.
And you're on a donut.
Right. You're on a donut. Your bumper is gone, but you have on Gucci shoes.
You sure made it. You're posting on social media.
They take pictures in front of other people's cars. Mm. It's just like, I thought you drove a Corolla.
I've seen that though. I've totally seen people posing in front of other people's cars.
Yeah, I have too. Like, I've seen a couple, and I'm that like, shit is not his car.
Not
his,
okay, yeah, that shit is not
cool. I'm just gonna mind my business and just keep scrolling, because maybe he feels like he has to pass something to prove to somebody. I don't know.
Exactly. And is that the guy you really want to date? Like, seriously, is that the guy you really
want? I've never really been into, like, you know, flashy type of guys.
I've never been into flashy anything. I always tell my friends, like, everything I wear, I bought at Ross. Like, everything I literally wear, I bought at Ross.
Right.
Oh, not the popper, not school.
It's another one. But yeah, like, I've never owned anything. Oh my god.
You get two more drops and then we charge 50 cents to clean up.
Then there you have to leave.
But we're like, serious about that popcorn.
I've never like owned anything like name brand, and like nor do I care. Like, even if I had money, like, I am not spending $300 on a t-shirt, because is just ridiculous.
Or shoes or a belt or purse, socks,
like,
or
how
women
are into these like Birkin bags, and it's just like, I'm not paying thousands of dollars for a purse. Nope. Like, I'm not.
The most expensive thing I own is this MacBook, and the school gave it to me. When I bought these microphones for the podcast, I bought them on eBay, like used and shit. Like, they're really good. Yeah. Like, I am so big on not spending full price on anything.
Absolutely. Like, it's what for?
What exactly? What for?
Like, you can get something like cheap that is like just as good as something that's brand new.
And I don't need to like impress anybody or like taunt or flaunt. Like, I bought this $300, I don't know, wallet or something. Like, who cares?
Yeah, like, I don't care how much your wallet costs, like.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to get by.
But I've been, exactly. I have had people try to, like, impress me with that kind of stuff. Like, okay, good for you.
Yeah, like, some guys think, like, that it's, like, that women really, which there are some women that really
yeah,
for
sure.
them that have money or whatever, but I'm not one of them. Like, I don't care. that you have stacks of money. As long as you have a job and you have a car and you're not paying child support to someone, we are
that's
good.
A big, that's an important one. As long as you're not paying child support, that's going to be the big one.
As long as you're not giving child support.
Because I don't need that. I don't need that drama. Hell no.
And that's not against anybody
that
pays child support.
Nope.
To each its own. But it's just not for
me. I'm sure you have a very lovely child. And you're beautiful. I just don't want to talk to you because I don't need that baby daddy. Don't need to be a baby daddy. I'd fight a baby daddy
Right, yeah. I don't want that drama.
I'm sure you have a lovely family, but I'm not going to fight your baby daddy.
Right, I do not need your baby mama pulling up at my job to fight me.
Oh my God, yeah. I don't subscribe to that. Actually, about social media though, especially before a first date, I know it's probably been a while for you, but like for me, there was a couple months ago, there was someone that, like, same thing with social media, like you start making a fantasy about how this person is. So like you see their picture and you're like, oh, this person must like be really adventurous if they always go hiking or this kind of stuff. So you have an image of who they are in their head.
Yeah.
And you get to know them and it's a big ass letdown. I had that happen with somebody. Like, they had this whole fantasy about how like the first date was gonna be, like what we're gonna do after, like the whole encounter. They had a fantasy about intimacy and stuff. And I'm like, that's so unfair because I can't even compete whatever that fantasy is. Like, I have no idea what that is. So like from the start, I've already let you down, and that relationship did not last long for good reasons, actually. Yeah, thank God. Thank God. I would have probably shot myself or something. It was awful. And that's not to say I wasn't a bad person too. Like, we're all shitty people at some point. But yeah, I couldn't compete with myself. Like, if you have a picture of me, of how I'm supposed to be, there's no way I can compete with that. And I don't want to.
Yeah.
I'm not here to compete with anybody.
Exactly. Yeah, that's how I see it. Like, in my Instagram bio, like, it's pretty simple. Like, I have Gemini and villain in my bio.
That's all you need to know.
I'm a Gemini, and sometimes I'm the villain. I'm labeled as the villain, and I'm okay with that. So I'm just letting you know up front. What
she's the person in the background that has a brick ready to go in case we need to fucking throw it.
Oh, I got it. No,
I fucking love that meme. Yeah.
Right.
When I think of you, I think of that meme. Move, guys.
No, because that is literally me. It's like, so funny that you say that, because last night when we were at that bar, but there was this guy named Robert that we met, and he was like, you know,
not a Robert.
Yeah, his name
not
was Robert.
A fucking
he
Robert.
Was pretty cool though. He was really okay. Cool though. He was. His name
I
was
usually
Robert.
When someone says and their name was Robert, I'm like, this is going downhill.
No, like, seriously.
What did Robert do?
Right, he's like, oh, Robert. They're not.
Is
really
this the
good.
Same Robert? Because I, I know a guy.
But no, his name was Robert, and he was from Oklahoma.
Oh God.
And I don't think I've really met too many people from Oklahoma.
I don't think I've ever met.
I was like, is Oklahoma even real?
I know, right?
It's but anyways, so he was like asking me like what I do, and like when I told him, he was like, oh, like I could see that for you, like you just have the voice, you know, for that kind of thing, like
okay,
you just have like
strange,
a really nice voice, you know, like if I were talking to you on the phone, I'd be like, oh, like this is a pretty nice girl. And he was just like, you know, you just seem like an angel, you know. And then my boyfriend and my brother were like sitting next to me, and they were like, yeah, she's not an angel all the time. Like,
if you knew.
Right, they're like,
if you knew.
They're like, yeah, we're gonna let you just have that little fantasy. Yeah. You're
never gonna actually meet her, but for your own safety.
Yeah, I'm just like, she's an angel now, but in the next 5 minutes she can be someone different.
Any number of things could go wrong.
Yeah, like, and I feel like that's how people, like, you know, because I'm a Gemini, like a lot of people give me the side eye when I tell them that I'm a Gemini. Like, they're like, you're a Gemini? And I'm like, what's wrong with that? And they're just like, oh, you guys are two-faced, you're crazy, and this.
But is there actually people that, like, genuinely believe that? I don't know. I've never bought into astrology or horoscopes. So, like, when people say that, like, okay, I can see what you're trying to say when you say I'm a Gemini. But, like, I never actually believed, like, all Geminis are two-faced and all Geminis are, you know, or, you know, whatever.
Yeah, which is not true. I mean, like, I do believe in astrology, but, like, to a certain extent. Like, I do not, like, base everything in my life off of astrology. Like, yes, I do believe that people do have characteristics, you know, because of their zodiac sign, but I don't feel like that defines them as a person and you automatically know them, because I've met other Geminis and they are nothing like me.
Yeah, it's not cookie cutter.
So you can't really like go based off of like, oh, because you're a zodiac sign. I'm like, what, like, what's your zodiac sign?
I'm a Libra.
You're a Libra.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Don't say it makes sense.
I got Pisces vibes.
Pisces? Okay, wait, why?
I don't know. Like,
what is Pisces?
Know.
I mean, I know what Pisces is, but like, what are some things about it that would make you say that?
I don't know, because like a lot of people that I know are like Pisces and they're just like really cool, like, and I always vibe with them.
Thank you.
I was just like, oh yeah, he's probably a Pisces because like I vibe with him. I vibe with Pisces or whatever.
I'm a Libra, but I've been told Libras are really good at mixing and like meshing well with the other ones, because we're like all about like peace and cool and balance, and that's one thing I totally stand for. Like, I love to like just keep the peace, like be cool with the, go with the flow. I don't want to make enemies. Like, if I think you're cool, I'm gonna talk to you. If I don't think you're cool, I'm not gonna talk to you. If I think you're really cool, I might send you memes, you know, or I might send you a song or something. But yeah.
Oh yeah,
I'm not here to make enemies, that's for sure.
It just depends on which one of me I am on one day.
True.
You know, I could be cool and peaceful, like the next day I could choose violence. No, I'm kidding. Yeah.
And some days you gotta wake up and choose violence. There's some days I wake up and I'm like, fuck, today's gonna be one of those days.
Yeah, like just based off of like your first interaction with someone, like you're like, oh, I can already tell
this
what
is
kind
me.
Of day it's gonna be. Like, and I noticed that like a lot of people, because I don't really have that issue out of people when I see them in person, like when the people that are in office and they're like in front of me, I don't really have that much of an issue with them like in person. But over the phone,
They grow some balls over the phone.
Yeah, they think that they're gangsters over the phone, and I'm just like, I mean, like, you want to be a gangster, I can be one too. Like,
no, they think they're all that in a bag of chips over the phone.
You know,
like,
and I'm just not a believer in, like, kissing people's ass, you know, to just give them what they want all the time, every time that they act up. And I'm like, that is part of the problem why people act like that.
Yes,
they know
that is why, because they know
they
can get away
like
with
that,
it.
That someone is going to kiss their ass and give them what they want. Mm-hmm. No, if you can't act accordingly and act like an adult, I'm not gonna help you.
Yep.
Like, I don't care what your issue is. I don't care that you're about to lose your leg or something. If you can't act right, I'm not gonna help
you. You probably deserve that shit. Yeah. If you can't act right, you fucking deserve
it. Right. It was probably your karma anyway. Like, cause who knows what other fucked up things that you've done.
Yeah, right.
You know, speaking of
some
that
fucking characters.
There was this guy that he was in the same grade as my older sister. My older sister's like 8 years older than me. So our trailer park was like, it was four streets, and then we had like a gas station. It was like a gas station / convenience store that was like a street over from where I lived. The man who like owned the trailer park, his name was Henry. When we first moved over there, like, I think he owned the gas station and the convenience store too, because it was called Henry's.
Okay.
And the guy that my sister went to school with, he lived like a street over. Like, we knew him because like we rode the bus with him, and my sister ended up like working with his mom at some point. Okay, so this is the convenience store, and then there's like the trailers right here, people that live on the same street as the convenience store. When he, I think he was in high school when this happened. I hope he was. So him and some of his friends decide it was a good idea. We're gonna rob the convenience store.
Oh, okay.
They rob the convenience store and they're like, we know he literally lives down the street. Yeah. I'm like, why would you do that? Like, why would you rob a place that you literally live
less than
a mile away from? You know, there was a point in time where there was a bank that got robbed by someone on a bicycle.
No.
And then they never caught him. They never
No.
caught him.
No.
He robbed the bank on a bicycle and got away. Like, no one ever knew who it was. Honestly, I never
Where is this man?
Like, suspect names. Like, they didn't even, I don't even think they had a suspect lineup for who committed the crime. I was just like, really? A
bicycle? The crime of the century.
He got away on a bicycle, like... See, that's the, like, one thing about living in a small town is, like, when stuff like that happens, like, it's just like, ooh, that's so scandalous.
Yeah, like, right.
But, yeah, that was, like, one of the
And they never got the scandals. Guy.
They never
That is a big scandal.
Him.
That's
Well, as far as I knew, like,
that's respect.
They never found him.
That's a real, that's a real criminal.
Got away on
That's
like,
a criminal.
How do you rob a bank? On a bicycle.
I'm guessing he had like a mask on, but like nobody saw what direction he pedaled to. Like,
right? I mean, like, cause you can only go so fast on a bicycle.
Nobody got in their car and just like chased after them.
Right.
And you can't carry that much money on a bicycle.
Exactly. Like, honestly, he probably lived down the street or something.
Mm-hmm.
Like, and he's just been hiding in plain sight. But yeah, they never...
And he didn't spend the money. A lot of people go buy a sports car or something. And yeah.
I feel like maybe he just got what he needed to pay his rent and just went on about his business.
And you know what? I respect that.
I
respect
like,
that.
Like, when they were like, yeah, he got away. I was like, in a bike? And I was just like...
He deserves it.
Kudos to him.
Don't even look for him anymore.
Right. It's like, what's the purpose?
If you find him, give him more money.
I feel like it might be like a cold case that might open up like 30 years. Like, we're looking for the guy that robbed the First National Bank.
It's like a TV show and everything.
Right, but yeah, it's on Unsolved Mysteries right now.
Is it really?
No. Oh. Well, it's on Unsolved Mysteries for my hometown. But yeah, like, I always think about that. I'm like, wow, he really got away on a bike.
He really got away.
Maybe I should have robbed the bank on a bike. Maybe I could have got away with it.
Like, you ever sit... Okay, I would never rob a bank. But you ever sit in line on a bank, you're like, you know, robbing this might not be so bad. Like, it can't be that
or
hard.
Or like, there's no security in here. Like,
yeah.
Police are not over here.
It's a bunch of old white ladies. Like, what are they going
to
do?
Yeah. You don't even have to have a real weapon. Like, you can pretend.
You can pretend to have a gun.
You know, like, pull the move where they're like, I have a gun right here.
Exactly. And it's your confidence, too. You just got to say it with your chest, you know?
Right. It's like, how do you take a person serious that tries to, like, rob you like that? Like, if someone came up to me, God forbid, I don't want it to happen, even though I'm talking shit about it.
Yeah.
But if someone came up to me, like, give me what's in your purse, like, and they just have their fingers, like, in their shirt like this, like, how can you take them serious? This is, like...
True.
Like, I would be
well,
like...
But if you don't know what that feels like, you might actually think it's a real gun.
That's true. I don't know. I feel like I would
But
be
with
like,
fingers, you can kind of know. Especially if they, like, press it up against you. Like, you can... Like, you know a gun is a lot thicker than that. Like,
yeah.
Yeah.
Like, it's like, you can tell. Or, like, you know, like, they used to put, like, the paper bag over there.
Yeah. Yes.
It's like, how do you take that serious? I would be like Drake on that episode of Degrassi when he got shot. I'd be like, is that a real gun?
Yeah. Yeah. Yes.
Is that a real gun?
If it was a real gun, you wouldn't find it behind the paper bag. You just show
exactly.
That shit.
Exactly. Like, what are you hiding it in a paper bag? Like, honestly, like...
You're trying to be sneaky? We know you're robbing us.
I know that's not a... You don't have a gun, obviously.
Oh my God. What could be under that bag?
Right. A like, bunny? You're holding it like this with it over your hand. Like,
right.
I never understood the purpose of that. Like, it's just like, are you trying to be discreet with it? Because, like... They're not doing
You're not
job.
Being discreet
like,
with it, yeah.
Even if you really did have a real gun in a paper bag, like, obviously somebody be like, oh, they have a gun. Like, yeah, we can tell that's a gun.
And then nobody carries money nowadays anyways. Like, if I got mugged, I'd give them my wallet. So what? There's no money in there. It's my debit card. I can cancel that.
Right. Like, I have a
I need
debit
a new
card
one anyways.
My account is in the negative, so I don't really know how far you're going to get.
Yeah, if you get a chance, put some money in that bitch.
Yeah, I'm like, you might want to deposit something on there, because I think there's like $2 left, so.
I don't know how many times I wake up in the morning and I'm like, negative $2 or something. I'm like, fuck.
And you know what's always getting me? Those fucking, like, Apple payments. Like, I would get a notification.
Yeah.
$4.99 has been taken. Like,
where?
What is this
From
for?
Where? Yes.
Like, Apple needs to be stopped.
Yes.
For sure.
You were charged $4.99. For what? I just paid the Apple Music, and then I forget that I signed up for that AI app or whatever, and now it's charging me full price.
You know, I'm still subscribed to, like, Uber Eats, and I don't even order Uber Eats, like, very
oh, really?
Often at all. And, like, every month, like, that $9.99 gets taken out of my account, and, like, I'm always like, what the fuck is this for? And
Does that give you free deliveries?
No, you still have to pay for delivery. delivery, even though you're paying for the subscription. Like, I don't know. I guess you get cheaper deliveries. I don't know. But you still end up having to pay a delivery fee, like, even if you are subscribed.
And you got to tip the driver.
Yeah. You know, so like, and then I just haven't canceled the subscription. I'm like, I get mad every month, like, oh, this $9.99, and then I don't
subscribe. And then you don't change it? Yeah.
And then, like, the process just, like,
repeats. I don't know how many things I'm paying for that, yeah. And then they always get me at the bad times.
At the worst
fucking times.
You like
I'm that. Like, I just paid all my bills. $4.99 puts me in the negatives.
Right. Like, you just have like $5 left, and then all of a sudden they're like $4.99.
And in my mind, I'm like, I'm going to go get a bag of chips and a Coke at the grocery store.
Right.
And then I'm at the grocery store and I swipe, sir, it's been declined. Like, first like, of all, that's embarrassing as hell. Don't say that. Right. Second of all, fuck, I'm broke.
I hate when, like, I remember one time I went to a gas station. This was actually like, so I don't know if you remember around the time, like, I had only been living here for 2 months.
Okay.
When my car got stolen. And it
I'm
was
so
missing.
Sorry. I should not have laughed. I'm so no, sorry.
Like, it, like, I laugh about it because I'm like, damn, like, somebody. Because I do remember. Like, just
I'm
imagine
so sorry.
Going outside thinking you're about to go to work and you're like,
and there's
where
no
the fuck
car.
Is my car? It was so traumatizing. I was just like looking around the parking lot. I was like, did I park on the other side?
Yeah. You start playing shit back. Did I park on
the other side? And then I'm like hitting the alarm button because I'm like, okay, because sometimes I'll hit the alarm button when I forget where I park. And I'm like, oh, there it is.
And you can hear it.
And I'm hitting it. And I'm like, I don't hear anything.
Battery must be dead or something.
Yeah, I was just like, wait, where's the car? It was just gone. But so my car was missing for like 2 weeks. And then they literally called me in the middle of one of my shifts one day, and like they like the police department left a voicemail, mm-hmm. and they were like, yeah, we found your car, and they took it to the fucking tow yard, which I think is bullshit. Like, I had to pay $250 to get my car out of a tow yard.
And it got stolen.
Like, I didn't ask for my car to get stolen. Like, y'all could have left this bitch on the side of the road where you arrested the people that stole my
and
car.
And I would have picked it up.
And I would have came and got it.
Weren't they wasn't your stuff still in the back or something?
They threw all of my shit, like everything that I had in my car, like there was like still, I had like clothes and stuff in there because like I didn't have my own place at the time. I was living with my brother. So like I still had clothes in there. They threw out my registration. They even took off my steering. Like I had this like this red like furry steering wheel cover.
I remember.
They even took my fucking steering wheel cover off. Like they took everything.
They were trying to be conspicuous.
Yeah. They took everything out of my car. But whenever they called me and I had to like go to the tow yard to go like pick up my car, and then so like I paid the $250, which was complete bullshit. I was
complete
like, what if
bullshit.
I didn't have the fucking $250?
They just kept the car.
And they were like, well, we'll just keep your car here. Like, I didn't ask for it to be stolen. Like, I'm a victim.
Right.
Like, what the fuck?
Right, but you're the victim
so
here. Yeah.
When I get in the car and I start it, like, the gas tank is literally like almost like empty. Like,
of course,
empty.
They're not gonna.
Yeah, they
gonna
drove the
in.
Like they yeah. drove like my car until they couldn't drive it no more. Like it was like this close to being out of gas. So I'm like, fuck. Like, how am I gonna get out of here with no gas? So
oh,
I go. So luckily there was like a gas station that was like right down the street from like the tow yard, and I go in there and I'm like trying to pay for gas, and like honestly I really just feel like the people in there were like, first of all, because they weren't really nice, and I really just feel like they were just like really like racist, like because they looked racist, and they were just not very nice.
Were they my color
at all? No.
Oh,
they weren't. They were okay. Not. But so, you know, I insert my card, and then like the lady at the counter is just like, declined.
Oh no.
Declined.
No.
Like every time I did it, she was just like,
no.
Declined. Declined. And I was just like, and then like I'm sitting here like, I know I have money in my bank account.
No.
Like, what the fuck is going on? Like, and honestly, like I kind of feel like they were doing it to me on purpose. Because when I don't really like to pay at the pump, because I know like they have like people that can like get your card information from the pumps and stuff, so I don't really like to do that. But when I paid at the pump, it worked. it didn't decline my card. So I'm like, were they declining my card on purpose? Like, are you serious?
Just to say decline, not like, because that's what hurts me. And like,
yeah, like, and the way that she was saying it, she was just like, declined. Declined.
And like, people can like, hear you.
Right, I was just like, can you lower your voice? I have money on my card.
Do you need me to show you the...
Right, I was like, I have money on my card. Like, so I don't... It must be something wrong with your card reader or something.
Well, and there's been times that I've been like dead broke and I still swipe it. I'm like, oh no, it's the client.
There's money.
There's no way.
I'm like, oh, I thought I had Spot Me on Chime.
Yeah, exactly. And I know damn well I didn't have no money. And
right.
I remember the joke I made now when you told me that you found your car. I'm like, imagine you roll up and you see somebody like at a like a corner or something. You see somebody wearing shoes and your shirt or like one of your dresses or something.
Your boots. Red boots.
The boots. What if you see the boots? You're like, I know what you motherfuckers did.
I was going to beat their ass if I ever would have caught them.
If you ever saw those red boots.
And you know what's crazy? I never saw the mugshot of a guy that stole like my car because the detective like gave me his name and everything. I never saw his mugshot because I was like,
damn,
I need to see this bitch.
It's on site if I ever see him again. Right. It's on site.
Yeah, so if your name is Jordan Hamilton and you stole a 2016 white Kia Rio. Shit.
It was Jordan?
Yeah, his name was Jordan Hamilton. That's what you said. That's what the detective told me his name was. But yeah, if I ever see Jordan Hamilton, like, it's on site.
So watch out, Jordan fucking Hamilton.
Watch out.
Or if your name is Jordan Hamilton.
Even if your name...
Even if you didn't steal the car.
Yeah, if your name is associated with that, like, it's up for you. So.
It could be Hamilton Jordan. You're fucked.
Yeah.
You just get beat up in reverse.
That, yeah. Like, your mom should have just named you something different. I'm sorry about it.
Oh, my God.
I feel like we've gotten so off topic. Like,
yeah, no, absolutely. Absolutely. No. But, you know, this is the part I enjoy the most because it takes a long time... Especially when you haven't like spoken to someone or your first time being on the podcast, it takes a long time to find the chemistry, to find the flow, to is it okay to joke about this, all sorts of things. So it's nice that we've been able to kind of match in and mesh in.
And don't worry, I'm not sensitive. Like I mean, like of course you know, like I have like such a dark sense of humor.
I joke about anything.
Yeah.